Hey, welcome to another episode of Stay Tuned TV. Hope y'all doing well today. Thank you for being here. So we're not going to waste no time. I have two stories I'm going to bring to you guys today. The first one involving R&B singer Anne-Marie, who was arrested in Atlanta, Georgia for a shooting. And the next story is regarding the passing of Wendy Williams' mother. So we ain't going to waste no time, and we're going to get right into it. So TMZ reports Anne-Marie, who's been arrested and is facing charges in the shooting of her male friend, was screaming and pleading for help on the phone before emergency responders arrived. The R&B singer's obviously overcome with emotions on the 911 call obtained by TMZ, but it doesn't shed much light on what happened in the Atlanta hotel room where the incident took place. At one point, Marie tells the dispatcher it was an accident and explains she reached for a towel and implies that led to her friend accidentally getting shot. Amid her screaming and crying, she's also heard saying, "I love you," to the shooting victim, 24-year-old Jonathan Wright. After several minutes, police and emergency workers show up and tend to Wright, and it sounds like they are dealing with a scary situation as they are heard trying to keep him awake and alert. So TMZ goes on to say, as we reported, cops say they got a call to the Intercontinental in Buckhead on December 1st and came upon this grisly scene. The police report says Marie was frantic in a hotel room while Wright laid on the floor with a bullet entry wound in his forehead with an exit wound in his left temple. Cops say the singer was emotional but not crying on the scene. She allegedly told officers a gun had fallen off the table and went off, shooting right in the head. After investigating, Anne-Marie was arrested and booked for possession of a firearm and aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. Wright was transported to a hospital in critical condition. So Anne-Marie is from the south side of Chicago, Inglewood to be exact. She's one of eight children raised by a single mother. She was signed to Interscope Records. Her debut EP, Pretty Psycho, was released in July 2019. I was not familiar with her music initially, and then I saw her on an episode of Angela Yee's Lip Service, and I realized we're both from the same city, so I decided to check her out, and I came to find out that she was actually talented. Anne-Marie was arrested in August 2018 by the Fulton County Sheriff's Office on a bench warrant for speeding, driving without a valid license, and failure to have a license on person. And in November 2020, she was arrested by the Atlanta Police Department on a simple battery charge and was released on a $1,500 bail. I heard the 911 call, and she was very emotional. It was hard to listen to because I can vividly picture this guy's life slipping away. I read the incident report and there were multiple casings found. So the narrative that she's trying to spin by saying that it was an accident most likely won't add up. I mean, this child just threw her life away. It's so unfortunate because she had a way out. I don't know if her mother and siblings are still here in Chicago or if they're in Atlanta, but I'm sure that they were proud to see Anne-Marie make it as far as she has. And I know her family probably depended on her. Now, I don't know what happened in this hotel room to cause this man to get a bullet in his head, but my heart goes out to his family. I did hear rumors that he passed, but I cannot confirm that at this time. You know, sometimes it ain't enough just to leave the hood. That alone ain't gonna always get it. You have to leave the mentality too, or it'll follow you wherever you go. Unfortunately, the music industry sees you as a product and a dollar sign and can care less about the artist's emotional, mental, and spiritual well-being. Unfortunately, money and fame will only exacerbate issues that have not been properly addressed pre to success. Man, this whole story is just sad, and like I said, my prayers are with both of the families that are affected by this tragedy. So that is that on that, and we're going to get on to the next story regarding the passing of Wendy Williams' mother. So Wendy Williams' mother, Shirley Skinner Williams, passed away at the age of 83. Wendy Williams announced the news on her daytime talk show earlier this week. Wendy is the middle child of Shirley's three children. Shirley and Tom were married for 65 years and raised Wendy and her siblings in New Jersey, where Shirley worked as a school teacher for several decades. Shirley worked at the Bradley School in Asbury Park as a learning disabilities resource specialist. Although she had to balance having a full-time job, a marriage and 3 children, Shirley made time to get involved in several organizations. According to APP, Wendy's mother joined the Monmouth County Council of Girl Scouts and the Central Jersey Club of the National Association of Negro Business and Professional Women's Club, Inc. Shirley also joined the Lambda Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Inc. Shirley said during an interview that she knew she could manage her personal life while giving back to others. "I guess my mother and father set the example for me," Shirley said. "They showed me you can still be parents and also make an impact on your community." So Wendy's mother and father retired, and after Shirley left her teaching job, she and Tom moved to Florida. However, the couple would frequently come to New Jersey and New York to visit Wendy. When in town, they will have front row seats on the Wendy Williams Show. And during the 2010 episode of the show, Wendy brought Shirley on stage. And Shirley spoke about how Wendy was born during a troubling time in her life. So she said, "In 1964, my family was full of stress and in a lot of darkness because my mother was diagnosed with colon cancer. It was not a good time for my family, but then a ray of sunshine came into our lives," Shirley said. "What a wonderful blessing it was to us that one was ready to be taken away in October and one brought a ray of sunshine and hope and wonderfully bubbly personality." So Wendy Williams shared that her mother died beautifully and peacefully. She also confirmed that her siblings, father and son, were there to say goodbye to Shirley as well. "I do empathize with Wendy and her family as well. I too lost my mom 3.5 years ago. I will say this, was one of the best kept secrets of 2020, and I ain't mad at Wendy for keeping this under wraps while she took personal time to grieve. I probably would have done the same thing given the situation. Wendy is a huge celebrity, so this could have easily been leaked, but shout out to her team for holding it down. Rest in peace to Mrs. Shirley Williams. I mean, she just seemed like she was cooler than a fan, someone that you would just truly enjoy being around." So yes, once again, my prayers go out to Wendy and her family. Well, that is all we have for this video. Leave a comment below if you have thoughts on the Anne Marie situation and or on the passing of Wendy Williams' mom. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, as well as click the notification bell to get notified when I upload a video. More importantly, stay safe, stay blessed, stay in tune, and stay out the way. Until next time, y'all, take care.